ready.
Still hear the music?
Yep.
There you go.
Yay! Alright, so new game, right?
Yeah, new game. It's a mess.
Okay. Leviathan, the last day of the decade. So I've, like, played the beginning of this game several times, but every time I try to play it, for some strange reason, it doesn't stream or record well, so I have to continue, like, replaying it. So I've already seen the beginning, so there's not going to be much shock and surprise in it for me, but that's okay. You guys will still enjoy it. Forgot my textbook at school. Whatever. I'm not going back to get it. What kind of idiot would walk all the way back to cross them, whatever, just to get his textbook anyway? That's a good question. Are you that? I'm not that kind of idiot. If Dorina were here with her carriage, it would be a lot easier. By the way, I wonder why she didn't come to school today. Probably because of the decade. Or maybe not. We're purebloods. The plague doesn't affect us. Dot dot dot. Man, this hat is really heavy. Why did I even agree to do this ritual? I just hope my mother doesn't see it. How would I explain someone's severed head getting into my bag? How would you explain that to your mom?
What, having a dead body?
Having a severed head in your bag. Like, how would you how would you explain that?
I'd be called the devil.
How would you be called the devil? Technically, I mean, you know, Oliver Bertram. Your little friend ran away from us today. What a scaredy cat. Is it true that he's queer? I don't care. Yes, we make out all the time. Sure it did. All Kale's fault. Okay. So now I gotta make a choice. Let's just stare at them. Oliver looks at the children in front of him, scowling. Yeah, I'm scowling. So this one is Groth Holyfield. That's a really ironic last name if you think about it.
Is there music playing in your ears?
There's no music right now.
Okay, because I'm sitting here like, why is there no music?
Yeah, there's no music this part, yeah.
Okay.
This is Lars Fanstein, or Steen, or whatever, and then this is Myrtle Rosewood. Look at Myrtle's face!
When I look at Myrtle's face, her face isn't, like, finished.
It's like...
Yeah, it looks like it's, like, scrunched up.
It's all, like, me. Look at Myrtle. Our old coachman's cock that he sticks into all the hags in the district. Nice. Nice. These are kids, by the way. This one. Jeez, language, gosh. Sorry, I'm not reading out loud. Last one. Hey dork, why are you standing there staring? Cat got your tongue? I don't know what to do! What do I do?
Hey dork, what are you staring?
I can dot dot dot, yell shut up, or act.
I have no clue.
Me either. Let's act. Life kicks those who stand still. I guess that's kind of true. I don't want life to kick me, especially if it kicks me as hard as Groth and his friends do. I have to act now. Run away! You will be a coward! Run away! Hey, where were you going? Stop! We're running away! Look, he's running away like a rat! Bertrand, stop! Lars, throw a rock at him! Throw one yourself! What did you say? I said throw it! Ah! Ow, losers. Jeez. I don't know if running was the right decision. I have no idea if my actions right now affect anything else in the game, because I've never played this.
Yeah.
So I have no idea. Look at those clouds. Why am I so unlucky? That's a great question. Ever since this morning, first I failed reading, and I had to walk home. Mother fired the coachman, and what's the point? We don't have any money anyway. And father has gone missing. He's never been away for so long. Whoa. Ooh, should I do a fun accent? Oliver?
Sure.
Oliver? Oliver, is that you? Who else would it be? Your face is all swollen. It's difficult to recognize you. Let me guess, Groth Holyfield and his friends, right? They make fun of a lot of people, but only beat you up for some reason. It's because I stand up for Kale, and those assholes take it out on me. No, it's because you're a wimp. You should fight back for once. Thanks, Druna. Does it hurt? Let me see. Oh, it stings! Stop whining. Here, I brought you some healing potion. Take it, you rascal. It's no big deal, just a couple bruises. Boys always fight. You should be used to it already. Come on, get up and dust yourself off. You're terribly dirty. Why do you care? Me? I don't care. But your mother won't pat you on the back for ruining your clothes. Cool, now I get to click things. Yeah, click things. Did you want to ask something? Ask it quick, I have to run home. The decade. Did you hear that the decade has started? Yep. This morning the whole house was whispering about how the whole city is covered in a blue fog. Cool. I woke up today around 9 and heard some sort of buzz. Was that it? Yeah, mother and I went to the fish market early. We went before school. We were walking and heard a sound like a lot of people blowing into a large trumpet. It was so loud. And the tower? Covered in smoke. It looked like it was burning inside. Wow. Yeah, the commoners started running immediately. They panicked. Mother and I kept walking and saw how they were carrying bodies out of Vineyard Alley. It was scary. Are there people in the chat? Hi!
Don't say hi to me, I say hi to them.
Hi! I'm so glad you're here! Sorry. Yeah, right. Why are you lying? Everyone knows that people infected from the decade get covered in sores and start coughing blood. Wait a week and then. I saw it myself. Truthfully, I didn't see any corpses, but I really want to scare Dorina. Besides, Kale said that the old lady died from the decade. Or was he lying to me? No, Kale would never lie to me. Beatrice and I are going to the city tomorrow. We'll look around. If I don't see any corpses, that means you're a liar. Damn. I guess that little, like, chilling thing means I made a decision? I don't know. What else do you want? Did you skip school today? Why did you skip school today? I just didn't want to go. What's wrong with that? I'm a lot now after all. I'm allowed to do even more than just skip school, you know? That's not like you. It's better to skip school than fail reading. What? How did you know? Myrtle told me. So it was Myrtle? She is friends with Groth and that fat moron. Yeah, I know. She's the one who called and told me you were laying here. She asked me to help you. Weird. Oh, I'm already 8 years old and I still don't understand what goes inside these girls' head. Dude. Okay, listen. Listen. Some advice from a girl. It's gonna be a long time before you understand what goes on in girls' heads. It's none of your business. I skipped, that's all. I don't want to tell you. Let's talk about some. Okay, let's talk about your hat. Why are you wearing, like, dude, you can be nice. It's not that stupid. Is her hat stupid? He, which means he thinks it's stupid. It costs thousands, you know. Blah blah blah. Hat's hat. You don't like carrying hats. Why don't you just tell me? Tell me. Okay, I'm not gonna tell. Oh, she's bald. Dot dot dot. It's because we live in the same building as commoners. They're disgusting, gross, I hate them. I told father long ago that we should hire some poor purebloods to mop our floors and cook for us. But daddy doesn't listen. Oh, she got lice. Ew. Got it. Thanks for helping me. Yes, I am. Blah, blah, blah. Bye. Have a great night. The path behind the trees leads to the garden. Izen waves crashing in the distance. Oh, okay, so I guess we're by the ocean. Oop. The Vertra is engraved on one of its sides. Letter N is missing. I'm guessing this is my house. Mother! I'm home! Mother? No one's here. Mother must have gone to run errands. What's that strange smell? Wormwood. Yeah, it's definitely wormwood. I heard that when the decade starts, you need to burn lamps with wormwood. Why? Why do we need to burn lamps with wormwood? What's the purpose of that? Oh, are you hungry?
It's a piggy.
Nom nom. A pig head with smudges of blood. It's laying on a silver platter with greens and vegetables. Don't you want that for dinner?
Maybe the pig head, not the greens.
Disgusting. A cast iron Dutch oven. It smells like roasted meat, onions, and spices, and wormwood. It smells like wormwood everywhere. Okay, so apparently wormwood's gonna be important. Da 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 da. Old grandfather clock. Cool. Stairs. Oh yeah, that's right. I have to drink the healing potion. Okay, so one of these things is inventory, I'm assuming. Yeah, this thing. I'm assuming that's the healing potion. Inspect. Oh, okay, that's how you use items. That's good to know. I really want to sleep. Okay. Nap time. Oh, do I get to keep it? I didn't drink all of it? That's. Aww, I guess I did drink all of it. Lame. I don't feel good. I'm dizzy. Okay. I'm guessing this is my room. Actually, I know it's my room. I've already played this. What's that? What's that sound? I don't know. It's nice though. Oh hey! Alien! Look at those eyes! Okay, I'll click the green one. Hello? Hey buddy, how are you? Great, yeah, not bad. You woke me up, jerk. No, you are. Listen, don't sleep through the decade. How was the ritual? Did it work? Huh? I don't remember a damn thing, Kale. I went to bed right after school. What ritual? The ritual to summon a demon, sleepyhead. A ritual to summon a demon! Oh. My. God! What? Did you forget everything? On Tuesday, we stole Professor Kortnik's magic scroll. The scroll to summon a Vargoyle demon. And we're 8. Sorry.
All right.
We
Now you
read
just have
it, and
you
it
have a
said that you
booming
need.
voice.
I have a booming voice?
Yeah, booming. So it's like very can carry. So that's why I just pushed it back.
You cut off a head? Oh, Kale, you should have used a kitten's head. Wait, you don't understand. I found the beggar's corpse. The decade killed her. I cut off her head. It wasn't me, you hear? I didn't kill her. Okay, I believe you. Go on. Well, we gave you the head, the powder, the notes, and the scroll, and. Oh, sorry, I clicked a button. So now I'm gonna summon a demon. Okay. Let's go find things. Look, it's my nightlight! Okay, there's my toy chest, I think. I'm guessing that's my toy chest. Oh, is that the head? Oh, lovely. Can I take this thing? No. Can I take the things? Can I take... Oh, I guess I need those.
Notes of the dead. Notes of the dead.
Dude, you can hear your baby from here, man. Oh, I don't want to read that. Recently, decades began and all cross them as under a fog. Even the tower can barely be seen. It doesn't look that foggy out the window to me. Look, pomegranate. I need to look more carefully. How about in this book? Can I take the book too? No? Okay. Okay. Now I inspect this? I get... Whoa. Okay, let's see. From the distant past, an ancient enemy people knew... No, that's not it. Here it is. 1 of 4. To summon a gargoyle, you need 3 things. A corpse's head, notes of the dead, and magic powder. You will use to revive the dead. First, glue the notes on the chin and forehead of the dead. This is the first step of the rite. First, but important. Then grab the magic powder. You need to pour the mixture into its dead eyes. Now that the mind is sealed, the dead lips are shut and the eyes are obscured by red mist, a dark spirit awakens. Seems like an allegory. Oh wait, no, I don't want to read it again. Ah, I don't want to read it again. Okay, got it. So... where do I do this? No, I don't want to open the toy chest. I want to perform a ritual. Can I just put the head on the... Oh, look at that.
Ooh. His bones coming out of the bottom.
How do I just do the ritual? How do I...
The board? Don't you have to do it on the board?
Yeah, but it, how do... Like, how do I... I don't understand. What am I doing wrong? Can I take the knife? I'd like it. Oh! These are all the things you can touch. Ooh, 3 gold coins. I'm like, just like rummaging around. Okay. So, I'm obviously doing something incorrectly. Oh, look, hey, look! Gold! The Plague King? Oh, he's creepy looking. Yes, I would like to use the board, though. Can I... I feel stupid!
Can you drag the head onto the board?
I just tried that.
Oh.
I've done this before! Oh. Ooh, can I call him? He looks kind of weird. Ginny. Is that my sister? Oh. Heard about the eye? We live on an eye now? We wake up at 6 a.m. and go to bed at 9. Classes from 8 to 9, but there's no homework. That's good. Alchemy is stupid. Oh. somebody has a crush on Professor Roderick.
How old is she?
I don't know. I'm also dealing with my lightning, static, and arc discharges. If it wasn't for that gazelle wind smut, that sure brings me down. Last time when I showed her perfect ball lightning, she gave me such a bad look. She had to give me credit. It's infuriating. I'm here and don't like it without you, without mother, without father. And tell mother I'm very grateful that she's paying for my studies. I can't imagine where she got so much money, but thank her. Last time we talked, she said she found a way to deal with the family debt, and now everything is different. I wanted to believe it. Thanks for calling, Captain. I'm so damn happy to hear from you. Me too. Call more often. Don't forget your sis. And don't feel bad about father. Everything will work out. That was cool. I guess I could call Kayla. Dude, how do I use this ritual ward? Use. Is there a use button? There a use button. I feel stupid. I'm serious. Do you see something that I'm, like, missing?
Can you fold that little thing?
You do it later.
Oh.
First you gotta do the...
Can you see?
Ritual thing.
Move your hand.
Oh, you're so smart. Start the ritual.
It's the key.
I wonder if this is dangerous. Probably. Alright, so we have to do this thing first. What? No, that's the first thing you need to do. You glue the notes on. The thing, that's what it says. Glue the notes on the chin and forehead. There we go. And then you put the powder in the eyeballs. Ugh. Here we go. Lovely. Arrgh! Oh yeah! Oh shit! Oh shit! I'm a genius! I summoned it! Kale will die of envy when he finds out. Holy crap, my room! Look at this blood! It's like blood everywhere! It's like Blood City!
What he said?
No, that's what I said. Look at all the blood all over
Jesus,
my room!
Where'd I come into?
Look at that! Hey, shut it, you evil head. I'm your master now. What?
Cat.
Cat?
Chat.
Chat? Hey! How are you?
Don't be too loud.
It's so good to see you! I can't type, apparently.
You know that?
Yeah.
You do?
Yeah. Or, I guess talk to you, because I'm not literally seeing you. I'm so glad you're here! Okay, we're gonna call Kale, because that's what you're supposed to do. Oh, I have to actually physically call him. Okay.
He subscribed.
Yay! Thank you for following us, Richard. That's so nice of you. Thank you. I summoned the bark oil! Oops. She wants to eat me. What should I do? What should I do? What? Not good, buddy. Looks like you didn't tame it and it wants to kill you. Look in the scroll. There should be something about taming a gargoyle. Alright, look in the scroll. Unfold the corner. Here is written how to tame a gargoyle. The righteous enter thy body, O Leviathan, to sleep the eternal slumber of peace. The evil escaping the scaffold enter thy body, O Leviathan, as punishment. And those souls, forever unhappy, suffering and wandering, look for deliverance from their sorrow that oppress them in life and oblivion. Avarice, demons, and sorcerers, the cunning dark liars, tempt these souls and entice them with happiness attainable only in death, and the deceased will bow down to them. Look for deliverance from their sorrow. Okay. Call Kale again. Got it. I can follow directions. Blah, blah, blah. Etc, etc, etc. But she died from the decade. Kale, I can't promise her that there won't be another decade. What should I do? She will eat me, Kale. I guess that's his name. Kale. I think that's his name, right?
I think so.
Oliver, are you still there? Yes. I lied to you about the head. Remember I said I found it near the dead beggar's house? In fact, it didn't happen that way. What? How? I saw the woman's eye. I saw how they killed her. I'll send you a picture. It might help you somehow. Okay, Z's. Let's examine the picture. Noble vermin are beating up the lady on the busy street. Something I missed. Okay, these people maybe? No one is helping her. Aww. Okay, so let's talk to the Vargoyle. What made you so unhappy? No one helped, right? You were alone many years. You suffered alone in this world of apathy. I don't know if you had children. Maybe they deserted you or your life became even more empty and hapless. I'll help you, do you hear? Now you'll never be alone again. I promise I'll be with you always. I swear, do you hear? I swear! There we go. Oh look, my room is back to normal. There's no more death everywhere. Oh hey, hey, turn off the light, my eyes are watering. Unbelievable, it worked! Oh, master, you are amazing! You are oh, I didn't mean to click it. Sorry. Cool, I have my own personal demon, yeah. Name, your wonderful name, my master. I hunger to hear it. What shall I call you? Demon Lord. Should I give it my real name? I feel like giving a demon your name is a bad idea.
Yeah, don't do that.
How about just Lord? Wish to know my name, it's Edna. And what do you wish, my lord? Fruit, entertainment, or to kill someone? How about your story? Before my miraculous rebirth? Oh, you really wish to know? Then allow me to waste some of your precious time. Look at Winnie D talks, look at her mouth. I was born into this world. Felbud had a grocery store. He was a horrible man. He drank like a boar. Cool.
Demon Lord. That's what Taco Boy said.
Oh. He drank. Oh, how he drank. Would get drunk, lay down, all blue-colored and moan. And I, little girl, would put on shoes and run to the shore with a bucket. I would take water to him. That's how I met Joel. I dropped the bucket into the water and he fished it out from his boat. He gave me the bucket. What a good person he was. I don't care. You're right, I really don't, but I feel like I should be nice to you. My husband. Father accepted the marriage. Joel was a I can't talk today. Ravineer, and lived well. In the dead season, we returned across them. The rest of the time, we traveled here and there. We traveled, traded, but we couldn't buy happiness or health either. Joel caught a fever, got all yellow, and died after 2 weeks. Oh, that's uncool. My lord, it's sad, but I lost everything. I received nothing in return. A new boss took over the caravan, and I returned to cross them with my son. By that time, my father had died from drinking or disease, I'm not sure. The house was empty, boarded up. I lived there until what? I don't want to remember it, my lord. I would gladly cook those noble bastards in a boiling pot if my dear lord would let me. Can you? Wow. What else can you do? Oh, a lot more. How about a curse, my lord? A family curse? Or maybe a murder? I don't know if I want to murder somebody.
You have the three kids who are being assholes to you at the beginning.
Oh my gosh, but I don't know if I want to murder them. Let's not. Maybe you would like to contemplate a brutal murder. A very brutal murder. A very brutal murder of inhumane torture with death coming from the shock of pain. Thank you, Edna. And torture? Do you like torture? Water torture? Honey torture? What's honey torture? Maybe you prefer lashes. The rack, iron shoes are boiling. Would you like to see them? I'm a very gifted demon. Oh, I'm sure you are. Actually, that's not what I meant. Oh, I understand. You want me to drink someone's blood?
AJ says hi.
Hi, AJ! Oh, I was gonna say demon lord. Oh, I'm sorry. Gut or strangle someone, feed them to animals, or just curse them. Alright, let's go say hi to mom. Apparently she's home.
I think the reason why the alert didn't come up is because I have the gameplay above the alert in the chat, because the chat should be showing on the page as well. But that's my mess up.
What, are you leaving? I've missed you so much, and now, again? I have to leave, Sherry. They gave me 2 weeks, and most of that time I spent traveling here. Tonight I'll stay, but tomorrow, once the sun rises. Who is she talking with? I don't know that voice. It seems familiar, but... Mother? Honey, I was just getting ready to call you for dinner! Who were you talking to, Mother? You shouldn't be eavesdropping, dear. Your father is here. He is terribly tired from his trip and asked me not to let anyone in the room. You can see him tomorrow when he's rested. I want to see him! Go to the kitchen. Dinner is getting cold. Hi, Blaze. I can't see with you in front of the screen like that. Come here. No, you're alright. You just gotta come sit on my lap for a little bit. You're in the way of the game. You can't take my headphones with you. There you go. Blaze says hi, everybody. Blaze says hi. He's decided to come join the stream.
Meow, meow, meow.
Yeah. I'm here, dear. Sit. Eat. Why hasn't Father come out to see me? My lord, I terribly want to see how you eat your dinner. May I? That's the weirdest thing. I'm sorry, but like, how would you feel if someone was like, I want to watch you eat your food? Edna, what the hell are you doing here? Go away! Hide! Quickly! You'll scare Mother! Oh, no, 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 Master. She can't sense me at all. Demons are able to become invisible. And she doesn't care about us now. I'd wager that she's hiding something. Wanna know what? Wanna know what, Master? Just look at her. Stressed out. Strange. Do you think aristocrats act like that? Oh, maybe her family deprived her of her inheritance and she just found out. Or her family is really mud-blooded and died during the start of the decade. I don't want to scare you, Master, but try not to go to quarantined areas. Thanks, Edna. Won't this demon ever stop talking? I don't think that she can shut up. Oh, I should have known! Maybe your mother has a lover? Or two? Two lovers? And now she doesn't know who to choose.
Maybe your mother's a whore!
Now that's a good story. Anyway, I still like it more than anything else. Master, want me to kill one of them so your mother doesn't have to choose? You really want to kill someone, don't you? Look, she has, like, sparkles in her eyes. It's super weird. Edna, shut it. Please, I'm sick of your talk. Who are you talking to, dear? With my demon? No one. No one, Mom. You heard things. You should have said, we're hearing. We're hearing. I've become forgetful, scatterbrained. Your father... Mom, since we're talking about Father, why doesn't he want to see me? He's tired, honey. He's asleep. Lies. I can see it in her eyes. Lies. Edna. Eat, Oliver. I sent Catherine home and made dinner myself. Ever since I cut her salary, her cooking has become unbearable. She doesn't even try. It's like I don't even pay her. She's avoiding the topic of your father. Why is that?
Hmm?
Edna! Calm down. I can figure it out without your help. Why are you always mumbling? Sunday we've got an appointment with the Rosewoods. You know, Myrtle Rosewood won't marry you if you behave like you're crazy. Aw, I gotta marry Myrtle? I don't...
Squishy face girl?
Wanna marry Myrtle. Yeah, squishy face girl. Good! Look at good! I don't like Myrtle, Mom. She's like a boy and she's ugly and likes to fight. I think that's sexist. The wedding is far off, honey. It'll be many years before Myrtle becomes your wife. She'll turn into a real beauty, you'll see. Sure, she will. Don't believe it, my little lord. A woman's beauty withers right after the wedding. And if the marriage is of convenience... The Rosewoods aren't the most influential family, but you won't have to choose. Oh, my boy, why do things have to be this way? Why are times so tough now? Great question. What did you do with all our money, apparently? Master, keep away from her. Your mother isn't herself. Keep her within your sight, just in case. Okay. Stop. She's fine. She's not strange. She's just tired. No, I'm pretty sure she's strange. I think I need to stop, you know, being in denial. Oh, look! The horrid spots! This is like a... like the out damn spot from Shakespeare. This is like a reference to that. You know what I'm talking about? Like out damn spot. Look at these horrid spots on the floor. I keep trying to clean them, but I don't think anything will work. And the people, these people kept silent. They killed him with their apathy. Because that makes sense. That's a very... Who is him? The people? Spots on the floor? What are you talking about, Mom? Wake up. Huh? Sorry, my boy. I was thinking. Let's talk about school. Professor Kreis complained about you, and Professor Kortenix wasn't very happy with you either. Kortenix is always unhappy, Mom. I think he hates everyone. And Kreis is a nasty old man who reads boring books. And school is just boring. Although, I liked yesterday's lesson. Professor Kreis told us about demon rituals and sacrifices. He even cut up a chicken. What kind of school do they go to? What did you do today in class? I cut up a chicken. Did you really have to look at dead chickens? I don't think Kreis knows what he's doing. Probably doesn't. And Malvis and Sean argued over whose bodyguard is tougher? Sean had a mercenary. A cool one. Malvis had a girl. A mudblood. She had no fingers. Prostheses. I can't talk. Each finger was like a knife. It's probably difficult to live with knives for fingers. Yes. I can see that. She doesn't care, though. She's dead. And Malvis was mad at the... as the devil the whole day about it. Alright! Cool! I hope she didn't suffer long. When I was your age, I didn't care about bloody fights. My friends and I had books, magic stories about this and that. Well, you're also a girl. And I am a boy. And we played a lot. Have you heard of Secrets? It's a simple game, and we all liked it. You just needed to find a secret place and hide a gift. What kind of gift, Mom? Anything. I remember how Mabel gave me jewelry made of garnets and sweets. I gave her silk scarves and amber that my grandfather sent. Laughs. At the entrance of Crossland Academy, where I studied, there's a bugle statue. Mabel hid gifts in there for me and the bugle. Good times. Oh, I totally forgot about dinner with all this talk. Sit, honey. Call Ginny. We haven't had dinner together for a long time. Mom, Ginny doesn't live here anymore. What? How? No. Why is that? She left the city a couple years ago. You sent her to study magic, remember? Don't you remember, Mom? I'm so tired. I'm terribly tired, son. My memory, it doesn't work like it used to. Is she being, like, mind-controlled or something? Eat. It's getting cold. I feel like... Thanks, Mom. It's no worse than Catherine's, right? Go to your room, study while I... what is it? Did you hear that, Oliver? There was a sound in the backyard. I'll go see what happened. Master! Master! Didn't you want to see your honorable father? Of course, Edna, but Mother locked the bedroom door and has a key. I can't see Father until he wakes up. Oh, sweetie. I heard how your mother hid a key in the kitchen. I swear by Joel it's here. Yeah, then we have to find it. Okay, Edna, let's find it. Okay, I know, actually know exactly where it is. It's in the clock. Open. Fine, I'll click all the little buttons. It's the key! at that. How did I know? I'm pretty awesome. Yeah, your mama still likes to play secrets, my lord. So as we have a key with us, open the door, Oliver, quickly, my sweetie. Edna is right. I have to hurry. Mother says that my father is very tired, but I want to see him so much. I hope he won't be mad. Here we go. Dad? You asleep? Yeah, look at my dad. My non-existent dad.
It's a pillow.
I know, right? No answer. The room is empty and cold. It doesn't look like father is here. Dad? What are you doing here? Mom, I'm... And why don't you ever listen? Didn't I tell you not to bother your father? I just wanted to see him, but he's not here. Didn't you say he was asleep? He... Are you going crazy? He probably went somewhere. Maybe he couldn't sleep any... Just stop! Stop it, Oliver! Go finish your homework right now! Oh, okay, okay. Let me in! Let go of me! Mother, let go! Mother, how did father have time to leave? Did he, like, walk right past us? And why is the bed made up? Where are his things? He couldn't have traveled light. Steady, Oliver. It's like she can't even hear me. Why doesn't she talk about father? Don't stop, honey. Let's go. What did you have today? Reading? Then sit down and read and be a good boy. I've had enough today already with your teacher calling and all. If you're going to misbehave in school, then at least learn something. Mother leaves. Mother says that Professor Craze is a great teacher. I think he's a crazy old man. Only wackos would make me read such huge books. Is this the book? This is a dusty old book. The half-erased title is printed on the cover, The Most Important Events in the History and Geography of the Land of Leviathan. Grandfather said that many generations of Vertrons have studied this book. He also said that every pureblood family should have a history book like this one. Only nobles are taught in my school, so everyone in my class has a book like this on their desk. Professor Craze makes us read passages from it. The first pages are a long list of its chapters. What should I read? The Temple of Every God or The Decade? One of 18? Holy moly. A temple has long been veiled in the swamps of the north. It is a sacred, holy place, as is the Leviathan itself. Legends say that there an underground volcano exploded and vanished, and all that remained was an immense crater full of otherworldly energy. This energy penetrated to the foundations of the scorched earth, with a stream flowing into every vein and a light that was seen for many, many miles around. The light drew the attention of the people. Rumors spread to all the cities and towns. Hundreds made a pilgrimage to that place to feel its power. It soon became clear that the source of this great power was infinite. Light from the depths of the earth gave men energy, power, and long life to anyone who touched it. Next to the blazing spring of energy, wounds were mended, pain was alleviated, and chronic diseases healed. People moved onto the crater's slopes. They dug holes into the ground that smelled of smoke and lived in small, squalid homes just to be close to the source. So this is from, like, a blown-up volcano. Centuries passed, and the power that poured from the heart of the earth dried up. The light of that power inevitably faded, and the people began to leave that place. The land, once teeming with life, became deserted. Soon only those who cherished the land most remained near the source. They called themselves the Coens. And so the Coens established a council that is the... I was probably supposed to say they. They decided to restore the former power to the crater at any cost. Night and day they dug into the crater, and soon the fire shone once more, only 100 times more powerful. Those who suffered reached out to the volcano, but now everything was different. The Coens told them what they needed to do so the flow of energy would not stop, and the pilgrims grabbed their picks and shovels. The crater began to quickly grow. Many people cut up rich black earth daily in order to find the fountain of energy, not stopping even for one moment. The scrolls did not record the name of the Coen who offered to turn the mouth of the volcano into a temple of every god of Leviathan, and there were a great many in that age. He said, "Any blind believer trusting will take his idol and bring it. The source will give up its power, and you will give the source the power of your hands." Tribes and free cities, all people small and great, after those words were uttered, the populations moved to the Coen's realm with triple force. Millions of hands raised a temple greater than any in the universe in the mouth of the dead volcano. Each idol had its own chamber, and night and day its followers worked in the temple shaft, serving their own god, not with word, but by deed. Oh, okay. Let's look at the decade. Let's see what we need to know about the decade. The Great Plague, okay. Great Plague that covers part of the continents, leaving only the borderlands unaffected. A regular interval, sometimes only a few years pass from one decade to the next, other times 2 centuries may go by. The decade itself always lasts exactly 10 years, okay? One can predict precisely when it will end with an accuracy of up to a week. Decades present no threat to pure-blood aristocrats. Their noble heritage protects them. Mudblood bastards and commoners become sick and die, however. The number of deaths is particularly high in the capital. That is not surprising, and Crossman has always been at the heart of the epidemic. Okay. When the decade begins, the heavens darken and twist into an immense funnel, and a thick blue fog spreads from the base of the tower. The fog is the plague, the disease. Any mudblood who is caught in it will inevitably be afflicted. The afflicted can likewise infect others. Zombies! The infected experience great thirsts, chills, a fever, and a throat so dry that every time they cough, they start to bleed. Flies reproduce in open, festering wounds that produce vile odors. Dark, painful sores appear on the bodies of the infected. The disease rapidly progresses. Often the afflicted die within a week, while others carry on for 3. Out of 20 afflicted, 17 perish. There's no cure for the disease, although charlatans make assurances. The suffering of the afflicted can only be eased by giving him plenty of loads. Okay, now we're done reading now. My lord, can you hear that? Hear what? Edna, what is it? Shh, don't speak loudly, my wonderful lord. He's already here, in your parents' room. Question mark? A bad man. I can smell him. The air is saturated with the scent. Can't you smell it, my master? No, Edna. Strange! Such a strong demon, and... Are you sure you can't smell it? Oh. Mother! No, no! Beg you, no! Mother, mom! Ah, screaming! Go, go, go! Oh! Oh, oh my! Yeah, I think she's dead, sweetie. The shadow. Oh, there's 2 of them. Awesome. My boy, don't be afraid. Please, I beg you not to cry. I'm sorry, incredibly sorry that you had to see this. You're trembling. Calm down, there's no need to. Oliver, listen to me. I know that it was a monstrous thing for me to do, but there is no way to undo what has been done. That doesn't make me feel any better. You killed my mom. May what you just saw tonight be nothing more to you than a bad dream that will vanish with the first rays of the rising sun. Yet you will say to yourself, I understand everything. That was the last nightmare I'll ever have. I needed it in order to wake up, and if I had not woken up, my life would still be a dream. Go to your room, my boy. Tomorrow will be a new morning, the first morning of your new life. You are. So it's Ebola. Yes, it is kind of like Ebola. Or I was thinking more like the Black Plague. Just, you know, this like creepy Black Plague-ish stuff. Edna! Edna, where are you? Yes, Master. Edna, kill them! Faster, Edna! Of course, Master. This is how my story began. My mother was murdered on the first day of the decade, a 10-year epidemic that plunges our country into a series of endless deaths and funerals. The killer was never found, inquiries from the Bureau never found any evidence, and in all likelihood never really tried. No one cared. No one heard the tears of a young boy who made claims about a killer in a shadow. I ended up in an orphanage, where soon a new father adopted me. His name? Christian Orvid, the man who murdered my mother. When we met, I pretended not to recognize him. I may have been a child, but I understood this was my chance to get near him and exact my revenge. Who knew that it would take so much time? I didn't want to kill him. Rather, Kristen deserved to rot in prison for all eternity. All I needed was evidence. I just needed some evidence. But I found none. So, 10 years have passed. In depths of despair, I almost gave up. But one day, I got a call from my best friend. He was excited and said that I needed to meet him right away. He was talking, almost yelling into the phone about a clue he had just found. Something about a ring. Woohoo! Part 2! Musical interlude! Dude, so was that like just the like whoa. Was that just like the intro or something?
So it's Ebola.
Rocking out.
It's Ebola?
Yeah. I told him I thought it was more like the Dark Plague. The Black Plague. But it probably is more like our Ebola. And now we're going through this like cool rock interlude. With this creepy face guy and Kale, can you not turn your face that way? And a steamship and that guy who looks like his hand just came off? Yes! Is this Russian?
Yes.
Can I skip it? No.
Can you speak it?
Skip it.
No.
Like I was gonna... Whoa! Episode 2, Clues of the Past. And now we're on top of a building. Okay, it's Kale. That was fast, buddy. I ran as fast as I could, Kale. You know how important it is. 10 damn years and no progress has been made in the investigation. My guardian is free and no one cares about my mother's death except me. And suddenly you call and say you have, for the first time in years, a clue. Faster, Kale, what'd you find? Show me. Show me quickly. A what?
Clint hit.
A Clint
hit. Clues.
Oh, it's from, a Blues Clues.
From, Fairly Odd Parents.
It should be like Kale's Clues. Kale's Clues!
They couldn't do it, copyright reasons in, Fairly Odd Parents, they called it a Clint hint.
We should, like, have our little notebook, handy-dandy notebook, ready to take down all of Kale's clues.
Why does clues suck? The clue is, your mom died.
Look, it's a ring! It's a piece of polished amber with sharp, smooth edges. I've never seen a piece of amber cut this way. Was amber your mother's favorite gemstone? Looks like it. Hey, look, there's a VF on the inside. That's some jeweler's seal, Kale. Do you think he knows something? It's so familiar. I've seen it hundreds of times, but where? Look at his scrunched up face, like he's like, concentrating. Okay, sorry. I'm being loserish. I'll have to keep looking. Where have I seen a tree with gold coins? It's the Orvid's coat of arms. Kale, it's the coat of arms of my guardian. You noticed it? Oops. Something about...
You noticed it?
Something about noticing it. So my guardian... my mom had a ring that my guardian... I don't know. Aww, all I do is upset you. Sorry. Hugs. You're fine as a miracle. Aww.
The ring is...
Aw, he blushes. It's so cute. Now this is your ring, and take this document. It's a document from the Bureau. It says that the ring was taken from Sherry Bertrand. Thanks again. And your father? He didn't say anything about you taking the ring, did he? Father doesn't know. I stole the ring and ran. My father is probably searching for me now. I had promised him that I'd sort some documents by this evening. I owe you, Kale. How can I repay you for what you've done? I don't need anything, Oliver. Thank you. I thought you had some questions for me. Inspect. Is that... What? What about... Oh, you mean this? Father? He got so mad when I refused to pin this dumb thing to my clothes. I was forced to. He says that every Bureau employee should wear this ID badge. Has your father really chosen a future for you? Yeah. It's honest work. Can't argue with that. On the other hand, having access to the Bureau isn't bad. At least we got the ring, right, man? I didn't think that you would ever help your father again with work. He hardly drinks anymore, Oliver. And beats me less and less. Oh, that's so sad.
No.
Poor Kale. He's getting old, understand? Someone has to care for him. Someone has to help. Got it. It's unfortunate that I agreed to help today. On the other hand, you have your mother's ring now. I know it doesn't prove anything, but... What do we do next? You're right, the ring isn't evidence yet. It has the seal of a goldsmith. You need to find him and ask more about this ring. And buddy, don't forget about your studies. You said that your guardian hates it when you skip. I don't need you wiping my nose, Kale. I don't need a second Orbit in my life. Okay, okay, I'm going to class. Remember, after class, you have to go search for the jeweler who made the ring. Good luck! I like how there's, like, beautiful music and, like, random lightning
yeah.
in the background.
The music is a little low. I need to fix that next time, but at least we have your audio up, finally.
Look all the way... Oh, do I get to click on things? That's a creepy gargoyle statue. Kale said that he loves to come here in the morning and enjoys the sunrise sitting on the back of the
gargoyle. Hey, Mr. Zombiehead.
I think deep down he feels sorry that he had to quit his studies at the academy and work in the bureau. Probably.
Chat.
So, hi, Mr. Zombiehead. I'm randomly clicking on things because I'm not really sure what I'm supposed to be doing at the moment. Oh. Behind the thick, densely shifting clouds, a silhouette of the tower is seen. The mist surrounding it has almost disappeared, and only the lightning hitting it reminds me of the decade. Oh, so the lightning is from a decade. Got it. Okay, so now what do I do? What items do I have? I have a ring, I have 31 pieces of gold, and I have this document. A writ from the bureau with its seal and a large sprawling signature of the Inquirer. 1578. Wilbur Domian. Domian. I don't know. I still have my ritual board. Hey, whatever happened to Edna?
Who's Edna?
She was like the head.
Didn't she become free?
Why did she become free?
Mm-hmm.
I didn't free her.
I don't know.
Was it like a slot machine? It's an old scratch vending machine that sells various potions. It's been in the academy for ages. There are three small dusty windows displaying various shaped jars of concoctions. If you want a potion, you just have to press the right button and pay 14 gold. Oh, so like, does it tell me what potion it is? Intellect potion. Charisma potion. And power potion. Okay, I'm assuming I'm gonna have to fight at some point then. No, I don't want to open that again. Do I go up the ladder? Wasn't I- okay. Am I in a different part of the castle head? Where did I just- Do I keep going down? Am I in a different place? Now I'm confused. I think I already clicked on those things. But I clicked on those things too. I don't want to buy a potion. But I don't. Ooh, I want to snap off the stone. Let's do it. Piece of rock was put on later. Is there really a hiding? Why? Snap. Break. Fine. Guess I need something. Okay, so I need something to open that. Do I have anything? Absolutely not. Oh, hey, I can get the potion that makes me stronger, right? This thing. Yes. Ooh. Awesome. Alright. Oh wait, that's not what I wanted to. I think I have to drink this potion first. Cinnamon and meat? Ugh. Can I drink it? Can I drink it?
Left click it. Or right click it.
I just did. It won't let me click. Other click. Power potion! Yeah! Question, or that's not exclamation marks? Now that's a surprise. I've never seen such a big ruby. I bet a stone like that is really expensive. Can I? That fiery stone is cut in the form of a large red heart. Oh, I just took the heart of stone. Cool, I guess. Okay, heart of stone. A huge blood red garnet shaped like a heart. Okay, cool. So do I just leave now? What else am I supposed to do?
You got rubies? You got a ruby from it?
Yeah.
Don't you have to go to the dude, the gem guy?
Yeah, but it won't let me off the roof.
What's in your inventory?
Should I call Kale, maybe?
Yeah, should I call Kale?
Look at Zarina. I just met with them, I'll call them later. Can I call Darina? Okay, so I'm gonna be late to class. Am I supposed to buy, like, this heart potion? Cause this is... It's like a heart with a ruby. Sure. I don't know what good that did me. Probably nothing. For one woman at a time. I really have no idea what to do next. I'm like stumped. I probably brought the wrong potion too. I probably shouldn't have done that. Ah, I feel stupid. Oh. No, go away. I really do. I have no idea what I'm doing. Oh, I can drag the screen! Oh my god, I feel so stupid now. Oh man. Dude, I'm sure everybody is laughing at me right now. Didn't know you could drag the screen. There's, Darina.
That is some 60s hair.
I know, right?
70s or 60s?
Maybe a girlfriend? Okay, I won't bother you about it. I'm glad to see you, Darina. Yesterday you were pale and sad. I thought you wouldn't come today. What happened?
Wait, isn't that the bald girl?
Yeah. This is 10 years later.
Okay.
Something that no one should hear. Okay. Mitchell Raider. Look here, Miss Lautner herself is crying into an orphan's jacket. Tragic. Go on, whatever. I'll write it down. You don't have to hear these sentimental stories. I like her. She's pretty tough. Look at his evil face, man! Oh, her uncle is dead. That's why she's so sad.
Finally getting music.
Hmm. Wee.
Be in a better position.
Yeah, and then old insults will remember, and your smart ass papa and all your family will hang in the trees like ripe plums. Jeez, you're an ass. Can I punch him now?
You can put your elbow up here.
Oh no, it's good like this.
Okay.
Tightening. I knew it. Ooh. Oh, I do have Edna!
Oh, shit. Say hi to everybody.
Oh, I like made him leave. Hi, everybody!
Welcome to the stream.
Welcome to the stream! We're playing Leviathan. I'm excited. Mitchell is such a jerk. Yeah, apparently he is. I'm sorry about that. Don't listen to him, okay? You know he needs only one thing to ruin someone's mood. He succeeded. Although I feel bad regardless. It hurts, Oliver, to watch your family falling apart. Oh! What do I do? Help me out here.
Okay, let's see. It hurts, Oliver, to watch your family falling apart. That's to Baldi. You have a charisma potion?
Yeah, I have a charisma potion. A hug. I can hug her, I can kiss her, or I can say calm down.
So what happened to her? What's with her? Why is she all...
Oh, her uncle died. Help me out, chat. What should I do? Yeah. I think we should hug her personally, but I want to see what... To see what everybody says.
You have a charisma potion that will help to talk, hug, kiss.
I don't know if I need to use a charisma potion on her though.
What was the guy before? The guy with the grr face.
Mitchell?
Yeah.
Oh, he was just being a jerk.
To you or to her?
To her. I'm gonna hug her.
Okay.
I'm gonna hug her. Oh, I got a kiss! I don't get enough hugs like that. Or support. Aww. He sees it and tries to spoil me like when I was little. He's a funny old man. He's really funny and very kind. Jarena's father, William Lautner, is rather a nasty old man. His schemes in the council and huge bribes to the right people help the Lautners to stay in power. Look at her phone, it's crying.
Aww.
I better keep my dislike for him to myself. Hey, Oliver, are you listening?
Who's
I wanted
the guy
to
in the
show your father's.
Does it ever say?
I don't know yet. Whoa,
ooh.
That's pretty.
I like the artwork in here.
It's a large brooch. It is a thick greenish stone.
Brooch.
It's smoothly polished.
Oh, is that brooch or brooch?
It's probably brooch. Can I have one of these? I want one of these.
Sure. That would be cool to be made.
That was beautiful. If you're watching this and you can make something like that, please tell me because I will pay you for it. It's beautiful. Hey, it's the Master Jeweler VF. It's the same guy who made my mommy's ring. What happened? I'd like to know who made that. Don't ask why. It's important. Important? Okay, I'll tell you what I know. The jeweler is an old acquaintance of father. My father has been friends with him since childhood. They say that he's been making jewelry for over 30 years. Just think. But you don't know his name? Do you think you can tell me how I can find him? Sorry, I can't, and I won't ask Father. He's not up to it right now. I was starting to hope that I'd be able to find out about the jeweler with Dorina's help. Ha! That would have been too easy. Hey, did you see? Professor Craze just went into class, and he looks freaking mad. Come on, let's go to class. It's about to start. Oh. So these are people I can talk to, and then I can look around. Oh, I can talk
who
to this dude.
He?
I don't. I'm going to talk to him. Lionel Blackstone. Okay. Not looking up from his phone. Yes, Oliver?
Oh,
what?
We just got a follower.
Yeah,
sorry, I'm not able to see. Hold on. Thanks for the follow.
Thank you for the follow.
I'm trying to find your name.
Should I talk to more people? Whoa. Oh, I like the flowers in her hair. I want cute flowers. I'm gonna eavesdrop. And you? So you rejected him? What else was there to do? Kim, I can't believe you. He's a typesetter in a printing house. What should I have told him? My sister and I passed by and saw him carrying dirty buckets. He was pale and blue like a corpse. His hands were covered in ink. Gross. Date him? Do you think I'm crazy or something? Yes, yes, that's true, of course, but I still feel sorry for him. Well, go comfort that pansy. He's probably still crying in his pillow after yesterday's conversation. He's such a crybaby. And you are so cruel, Sarah. I'm surprised at you. His parents once sat in the council, and his family is more ancient than yours. Everything that is happening to him is just a combination of horrible circumstances. He needs your support, your compassion, and you... And I would. I want a regular guy, Kim. A regular guy, not a commoner. Someone who can give me gifts, flowers, and jewelry. Oh, Sarah. That's why I don't like to listen to women to talk. Sarah and Kim are just disgusting. Alright then. I'm afraid of tests. I sat in the library all night yesterday, and now I don't remember anything.
Say thank you to Philip.
Just don't
thank
fail
you,
the damn geography test. Thank you, Philip!
Hey, Miss, how you say his name?
Philip. Okay. I'm just gonna call you Philip. Person on the floor. I don't know him, but he seems to know me. We're in the same class, and I see him at school. Cool, I guess we're going to class now. Oh my gosh, look at Mr. Craze.
Jesus.
Ahem. Dear students, please hurry up and sit down. Class has begun. Is everyone present? It looks like it. Quickly, people! Mitchell, stop chewing gum. Aren't you ashamed to do that in class?
Look, he balled up his paper.
And stop grinning. Sit down, sit down.
It looks like Craze is in a bad mood today. Look at him. He's about to explode with anger. Or maybe from an inflated ego? I know that it's not good to talk about professors like that, but Craze seems so... pathetic.
Let us begin.
I want to listen to Dorina. Craze is muttering something in the background. Geez, Craze is so boring. I just can't listen to it anymore. Did you hear what's happening in this city? A lot of things are happening. Oh, it's a guy. A lot of things are happening. What exactly do you mean? About a week ago, something strange started to happen, Oliver. Strange and terrible.
Read the chat.
Yay! Philip from Dugout! I'm so excited! Thank you for watching me play. That makes me feel special. Aw, I feel special. You're so nice. Thank you. Steiner, my mother's friend? Lillian Steiner? Yeah, so you've also heard about the horrible thing that happened. It's true. Her head was... Wait, I didn't hear what happened. Tell me. Lillian Steiner was found dead last Wednesday. Headless, Oliver. Headless. I wonder if someone's trying to summon another Edna.
Uh-oh.
They found the head later. In the fireplace. Oh, that's okay. Oh, it's so terrible and disgusting that I can't even think about it. Can it be that the Steiner family really is cursed? Oh, I don't know. I didn't curse them, though. That's nonsense. Just a coincidence. Coincidence. Well, years ago, Lillian's son went missing. They found his bones last year. The boy was strangled with a collar. Oh, it's so terrible. Although, compared with what's happening now downtown, marauders are killing the infected and burning them. They rummage through their ashes looking for gold and jewelry. That's what Father says. It's terrible if it's true. People are acting like animals. I'm not even sure we aren't animals. We're nobles. I don't believe these riffraffs are people. The decade is about to end, so why is everyone so scared? I don't know. It seems like it's especially alarming to live through most of the epidemic, but then die when it's almost over. Mr. Bertrand, stop making noise during my lesson!
Miss Lautner, what was I just saying a minute ago?
I don't remember what voice I had for him.
Oh, crap. I don't know what he was talking about. Eeny, meeny, miny, moe. Catch a tiger by... This one. Sir, you were talking about the history of our country's birth, about how the people found the Plague King, and... Enough! I see that you were listening to my lectures. Oh! Yes, I guessed right!
Lucky guess.
Oh, I got another kiss! Thank you, Oliver. Oh, look, I got a little... She gave me a little heart thing on her phone. Thank you, Oliver. Thanks a lot. You'd be right if you said that I never learned from my mistakes. Let's just talk, okay? There's nothing to do during Cray's lessons.
Mrs. Lautner, I've already warned you. I talk about things that everyone should know, especially noblemen. Yet the strange creature kept roaming around in the field as if he were immune. Soon the archers who shot at him began to die. They started to rot and burn. They started to panic. The army scattered in all directions, but it was too late. Death had cut them down. None of the archers left the field alive.
Oh, thanks, Philip. It was a good guess.
The nobles watched as their armies perished. After taking counsel, the elders took a cup, filled it with their own blood. They brought the cup to the creature roaming in the field and fell to their knees before him. After drinking the elder's blood, the creature departed into the tower. His name, the name that inspires awe and terrifies the living, was invented many years later, and his name is the Plague King.
Okay. Why would you build a city around a Plague King?
No clue.
Like, why would you do that?
People build cities near volcanoes and such.
Yeah, but the Plague King is like, he plagues them. He has to drink their blood.
What?
Like, why would you build a city around that?
I have no clue.
Seems incredibly boring to Oliver. I'm sure it is. It's probably best not to disturb her. Sleep in class, try to leave, ask to be excused. I'm gonna sleep. Ooh, that's pretty. You have grown up just as fate has foretold. I don't know if you're a girl or a guy. I don't know what you're supposed to sound like. You Bertrands are alike. The hunter's spirit awakens in you like clockwork. It is strong like steel, but miraculously you are able to maintain your free will. Where are you? Who's talking? I am in front of you. I am the tree. Oh, you're a tree! Oh, that's so cool! And from now on, you always call me the tree. I like the name. It's easy to remember. Do you have any questions to ask of me? Ask. Okay, where are we? Young Bertrand, you are in the land of dreams. Time doesn't pass here like it does in the outside world. Okay, it's another demon. What do you all need from me? No, no, no. I am no demon, Oliver. In my world, this world is free from aberrations and evil. What's that mean? What is really happening here? I am the Bertrand tree. I have helped your family for hundreds of years to be pure, keeping them free from demonic corruption. Oh, oops. I already summoned a demon. Does that mean I'm not free from demonic corruption anymore?
I guess so.
What corruption? It is your family's job to fight aberrants and villains, and you, and all Bertrands, should walk along your predetermined path of destiny. Oh, so I guess my father disappeared killing something, and I guess died. I don't know. I'm gonna just guess there. However, you cannot fight filth and remain clean. Everyone becomes tainted. Can you be more specific, tree? I don't understand. You are a Vertron, a demon hunter by birth. You must stay as pure as possible. Sweet, I'm a demon hunter! Yes!
That's cool.
I like it. Only 5 steps separate you from falling into the abyss of aberrance. 5 evil acts. Oops. Okay, 5 evil acts. I can only do... Ooh, yeah, I know. I have strong ties to the world of aberrants. I kind of summoned a demon when I was a kid. Okay, so I can't make 5 mistakes. If I make a 5th mistake, you will become one of only 3 Vertrons who turn to aberrancy, and I will kill you. Okay, I'm gonna get killed by a tree.
Oh, shit.
Hey, now, hold on, tree. Aren't you afraid that I'll kill you first? You cannot kill me. It's unlikely that you need to kill me anyway. If you try, it will just increase your aberration level, nothing more. I'm gonna ask. I don't want to increase my aberration level right now. What is my aberration level now?
Yes, I'm a zero! Yeah! I don't know how I'm a zero. I am proud of your purity, young Bertrand. That's right. Oh, okay. I'm not comfortable here, Tree. If this is a world of dreams, then I can wake up at any time, right? Yes, you can wake up whenever you wish. Oliver Bertrand, son of Roger Bertrand. Then I want to wake up as you wish. We part, but not for long. From now on, we will see each other every time we fall asleep. Oh, that's exciting. I get to see the tree every time I fall asleep. I want to see a tree every time I fall asleep. Why can't I see a tree every time I fall asleep? That would be so cool. Guard your mind, Oliver. Guard yourself. Okay. Mr. Bertrand, the lesson is over. Were you so tired that you preferred to sleep through my lecture about how the First Council was formed? No way, Professor. I could repeat your lecture word for word. Psh. No need, Mr. Bertrand. As you can see, the lesson is over and everyone is gone. You go too. Yay! Thank you, whoever followed us. Who just followed us? I want to say thank you.
Oh, and not him. No, that's the guy's watching you right now.
Okay, I really appreciate it. Thank you for following. Sorry. So now I can look at the books. A message is scratched into the desk. Guys, Dolph, Mitchell, Lionel, and everyone who gave me money, read. I stole the old man's answers and hid them in a secret place. Not the usual place, but closer to the water. I wrote a sign on the rock so you won't get confused. Look for it carefully. P.S. Mitchell, you owe me 17 gold, you greedy bastard. If you don't pay, there'll be no more answers and you'll screw your friends. Okay. From where I am, I only see a part of the inscription. From the outside, completing the so-called cycle of the 16 elements, the cycle of the expanded circle. Virtually the entire board is dotted with columns of magic formulas, pictures, and incomprehensible symbols. Craze, like usual, decided to prepare early by writing tomorrow's magic lesson on the board. Are you still here, Mr. Bertrand? Hurry up, please. Oh, okay, I'm leaving. Fine. My lord, I'm here! Hi, Edna. I'm surprised that you're on time. Usually you're late, Edna. That isn't fair, my sweetie. I heard a story about a demon who was 110 years late meeting his master. Of course, the meeting never happened. Not the best example. Try not to be like that demon, okay? Here, take a look, Edna. It's a ring that Kale gave me. Ooh, it's a lovely shiny ring. Master, I know a shopkeeper who would buy a treasure like this. 70 gold? Yes, yes, 70 gold we'll get for it. Edna, stop it. The ring is an important clue. What do you see? Oh, so that's it. Let me think, Master. Silver. Almost pure silver. Matte lacquer on the metal and stone. The stone is especially beautiful. Forget about the stone, Edna. Better look here. On the steel. On the seal, sorry. I need to know everything about the jeweler who made the ring. Curious. I've seen that stamp somewhere. But I don't remember where. Want me to find out everything about this ring? I'll do it, Master. Just say the word. Yes, Edna, I want you to find this master jeweler. Duel it for me, okay? As you wish, my lord, I'm going to find the jeweler. Edna slowly disappears into the air. Aha, you son of a bitch! I saw it all, dork! You were talking with a demon, you aberrant dick! What do you have to say now? Craze will love to know that his favorite student is rubbing shoulders with creatures of the dark, and won't your guardian be proud? Bertrand, you're screwed! Stop, you rat! What a setup! Mitchell runs away. Oliver, we're in danger! That boy saw us! We need to do something! Edna, I'll talk to him. If he says something, I'm screwed. I'll go to jail, something. Go talk to him, I'll stay here. If you need help, just screech, like a seagull, for example, or like a pelican, or a gannet. Screech like a gannet! Do you know how to screech like a gannet, sugar? I think I'll just call your name, Edna. Okay, so I gotta go find this dude. Did he go this way? Secret combat punch of the Great Raider family. Ha! Thanks. Don't come near me ever. Ah! No need to get guards. Mitchell, enough! Mitchell, listen, I don't want to fight you. Don't talk to me. Not the best idea. I guess I'll fight. Defend. cool. Uh-oh. Oops. I think I killed him.
What? Did you do that?
I'm sorry!
Remember, you had the strength potion.
No, but I didn't have it on.
No, you drank it.
He said Edna go. Yeah, Edna went, and Edna killed, I think. I think we accidentally killed her.
Him,
whatever.
Jesus, girl.
Stop pretending to be Ben!
Is she punching him?
He's dead! Oh god! He's dead! What do we do? I'll be sent to prison! Oopsies. I guess that's not. Like every good demon, I have a few suggestions, sweetie. First of all... Edna, who's there? Go look! Just don't get noticed. A moment later, sweetie, it's your teacher. He seems to have heard a noise, walked out of class, and is coming here. You know, Craze is such a cutie. I never thought I'd hear that. I'll distract Craze, and you take care of the body. And wash the blood from the walls. Sweetie, what do I do with the corpse? Think of something! Who's the evil flying head, after all? Oh, no, no, sir. We Vargoyles are made to take orders. Tell me exactly what I need to do, okay? I need to think quickly. What do I do with it? Eat it! Oh my god, I can make her eat it?
I dispose of the body.
Well, I could throw it away, send it to the demon world, or eat it.
I think if you send it to the demon world, I'll come back.
Let's eat it. Eat it, Edna.
Okay. I'm yum 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 yum.
Oh, I can't believe I just killed someone. Were you making noise on the ladder? Yes, yes, I was.
Soccer boys in demon world. Nope. Too late.
Sorry, I had Edna eat him. I apologize. Commendable honesty,
he'll
but why?
He'll come back as a spirit detective.
It was love. It was love. Oh my god. We're rehearsing. What are we rehearsing for? It was love.
The death of a salesman.
If you ask me like that, then I won't tell anyone. Is it something private? Yes, Professor. It's hard for me to talk about it, but today I told a girl that I love her, and she didn't say anything. She rejected me, understand?
Yeah.
I hope I'm not overplaying my hand. Oh my god.
I just see him running with
a
flimsy arm.
I feel sorry for you, Mr. Bertrand, but those cries on the stairs. Yes, sorry, teacher. I wasn't myself. I screamed, cried, beat, and kicked everything. I nearly broke. What? What did you almost break, Oliver?
A dude's face.
The vending machine. This vending machine with potions. I was near it when I was angry, so I hit it a couple times. You hit the vending, whatever. Dang it.
Hit whatever.
No! Dang it!
What happened?
Damn it.
What happened?
Oh, I made the wrong choice.
What happened now?
I should have, he went up the stairs. I was trying to distract him. And I should have said, I could have picked my hand or the vending machine, so I fit the vending machine because I thought it would make more noise. But now he's like, oh no, I have to go see it. It's Academy property. And now he's gone up the stairs and... Oh. Oh, no!
Failure. Oh. Well, knowing now you can fail and do stuff like that. So, what I did was, I went into Facebook, and this guy was talking about send your,
see a doctor. Okay.
You send your,
thank God.
Links to him, and he'll send people to kind of look, and he checked out yours. He says you sounded like a streamer, somebody foxes.
Me?
Yeah, there's a streamer that you sound like, just like him. He says the mic quality is awesome. It's just really low, but I don't know if it was him because it sounds great over here. So yeah, anyway, continue.
So does that mean I'm doing a good job?
Yeah, he says the quality of the mic sounds great.
Yay!
And the only thing is that he said that you sounded low. That's the reason why I was turning it up and brought it close to you. But you sound great on my side, so I don't know if it was him or me.
Oh, well, thank you. I'm so glad I sound... I'm doing well. That makes Merritt happy.
Yeah, you know, I rather enjoyed it.
Hey, what happened to him?
Sure you did, Edna. She enjoyed killing him. I don't feel bad or any remorse about it. Oh, man. Of course I'll find him, but you, Master, don't forget to ask people about the seal. Maybe they'll tell you. So, I'm an idiot, and is there any way I can talk to the tree and see my, like, stupidity count? Like, is that possible?
I have no clue.
Oh my gosh. Okay, that's too many things. Hello, person. Sir, bowing her head respectfully. Oh, you're a girl? But you have a boobie showing.
What? Where? Oh, that's a dude.
But it says bowing her head respectfully.
I don't know.
Cool! Alright. VF. I don't know how to answer, sir. Okay, there are so many people in the city who's with those initials that I couldn't tell you anything concrete. Okay, thanks for the help. Anytime. Cool. Thanks. Hello, chick with the big book. 207 and right behind it, 210. Does it make sense? Certainly today, right now, stupid book. Okay. What happened? Maybe I can help. It's this book. Look at it. Just look. It's so old that it's falling apart. Oh, look. This page fell out. 10 minutes ago, I saw a piece of paper get blown by the wind toward the academy. I didn't think anything of it. I didn't know it was a page from my textbook. Oh, if only I had just looked at it. Will you help me? I really need my textbook. I would have bought a new one, but my aunt is an old greedy hag. She never gives me any money. I'll find the page. Slowly. The page was being blown around here in the courtyard, and then a sudden gust of wind took it and carried it off somewhere. The last I saw it, it was floating over the gargoyles that decorate the academy roof. It flew up, and I lost sight of it. Alright, so then I guess we'll go to the roof and see if we can find the page. Can't believe I killed a person. Oh, there it is! Yeah, I win. Points for me. What?
I just got back to you and he said, I can't believe I killed a person.
I can't believe I didn't mean to kill. Well, Edna killed him. Here you go. Did you know that you're cute? We should talk tomorrow during break. So take this power drink as a gift. My aunt gave it to me so I can stand up for myself in case of danger, but it might help you too. Oh, thanks. Zusha says that the sky is a large mirror woven together from smoke. A mirror, yeah. What? Don't understand. I'll explain. You see, here's the Leviathan. It's huge, right? And everything happens on it, you and me and everything. Well, and look, we learn everything in this world by watching others. Okay. Like a mirror, okay? It's okay, you'll get used to killing? Okay, I guess, if you say so.
Soviet Russia, you kill a lot of people.
But I'm not in Soviet Russia. I need a mirror. A mirror because the mirror was here. He told us to look at it. He exhales smoke, so we look. That's the way it is. If you don't want to exhale smoke, look at the sky. It's full of smoke. It's a mirror too. Got it. Don't forget to see the mirror because it's everywhere. Hey, look! There's my chica. Bodyguard. We're just gonna leave her be. I didn't know you were still here. Were you waiting for me? Maybe you wanted to take me home? Dorina, remember the stamp that was on your brooch, you know, VF? Of course I remember. I actually called my father and asked him about it. He said that the jeweler lives in the White Circle District. It's a horrible place. Do you know how I can get there? It's not far, Oliver. You just get on the metro and you're almost there. Oliver, you never answered. Want to take me home? Sure, let's flirt. Uh-oh. Oops. Maybe that was the wrong thing to say. This is villainous. Whether my father just grown a villain, you're still too young to fully understand. What if this man was from the cult or a scumbag? Maybe the warrior with the knife hunts demons, he said. I didn't know how to answer him. I'm just pushing things now. Oh! Okay, now it's green. Oh, I'm guessing this is a metro. Look at this dude's, head. Okay. Alright, well, unfortunately, guys, I'm gonna have to stop here. I'm sorry. But I thank you guys so much for watching me stream and for being here, and I hope you'll join me next time I stream, so I wanna stream some more, so hopefully I'll finish this. But thanks again, so I'm gonna sign off. Bye, guys!
Did you save it?
I did.
Okay.